Good afternoon. My name is Aman Paul. I'm currently working as the Director of Product Development at Protex. Today, I'm invited here to speak on insects as health promoting animal feed ingredient. Here, you can see the content of my presentation. First, I will explain something about my employer, that is Protex, then briefly covering the need for alternate proteins. We will zoom into the functional benefits of dietary insect proteins, fats, chitin, and live larvae in animal diets. Then I will try to summarize my presentation. Now I'll talk something about my employer. Since its foundation in 2009, Protex has become one of the leading insect ingredient company with expertise in black soldier fly rearing. Protex has currently the biggest operational insect production facility in the whole world, which was inaugurated in June 2019. This is something that we really say with pride, that King of Netherlands, Willem Alexander, came to inaugurate our production facility in 2019. And this is visible in the photo on the bottom right. Next slide is about the need for alternate proteins in animal feed industry. The population of Earth is expected to touch 10 billion by 2050. This will increase the demand for animal proteins by 52% in next 30 years. The conventional sources of animal proteins that are commonly used in the feed industry are already associated with several environmental issues. The graph in the right basically indicates the kilograms of carbon dioxide emissions that are associated to produce per kg of animal proteins. In this graph, a comparison is also made between the human food grade product and the byproducts that are normally used in the animal feed industry. With such a high greenhouse gas impact, it makes very little sense to rely on the conventional sources of conventional animal proteins to meet the increasing future demand. And this really fuels the search for alternate proteins that could be successfully used in the animal feed formulations. Out of all the insect species that are being considered for animal feed, black soldier fly or Hermesia lucens larvae is unique. Basically, due to its ability to grow on wide range of organic side streams. In nature, these insects grow in extreme conditions. Hence, their body is equipped with genes that produce bioactive materials, such as peptides, fatty acids, chitins, etc., that help to protect these larvae against pathogenic environments. For example, the microbial invasions. When these insects are basically fed to a host animal, these bioactive molecules can also benefit the host animal by improving their health. This slide basically indicates what exactly we do at Protex. We feed the BSF larvae with food industry byproducts. The harvested larvae are minced, thermally processed to reduce the microbial load. The pasteurized larvae meat, which we sell in the market by the brand name of PureX, is sold as protein source to the pet food industry. This pasteurized meat is also further separated into proteins, lipids, which are used as functional feed ingredients in pet food and animal feed industry. The digested material from insect is also sold as organic fertilizer for plant nutrition. We are also currently busy in the development of next generation insect-based feed ingredients. I will also provide a small glimpse of one such ingredient in my next slide. Coming to the next slide, I will basically share some latest insight regarding antimicrobial properties of insect proteins. There is already some literature regarding the presence of antimicrobial peptides in black soldier fly larvae. Some researchers have also characterized the in vitro and in vivo antimicrobial activity of insect peptides against selective pathogens. There are also reports indicating that inclusion of BSF protein meal improves the gut health of weaning piglet. However, pet food is currently the biggest market for insect proteins. However, there is no literature that evaluates the antimicrobial activity of insect proteins using models that are relevant for pet food industry. Keeping this in mind, as a part of PPS project, Food and Biobased Research Group from Wageningen University and Research conducted in vitro experiments to evaluate the antimicrobial activity of insect proteins against Clostridium perfringens. Clostridium perfringens is also a major pathogen in dogs and cats. During this research, BSF protein meal variants, BSF chitin, and mealworm protein and mealworm proteins were first digested using the InfoGest model, which basically simulates the digestive system of dogs and cats. Then the digests were incubated with Clostridium perfringens for 24 hours to see the inhibition effect. Here you can see in this graph, which I present here, that both the BSF protein variants exhibited very strong anti-Clostridium perfringens activity that was significantly better when compared to control as well as mealworm proteins. This research is basically now submitted for publication is currently in the peer review process. In this slide, I will discuss about the immune response modulation properties of insect proteins. There is already a paper that shows the immune response modulation effect of dietary plasmodified proteins in dogs. However, the exact molecular phenomena behind this effect has not been discussed till now. The photo in the slide basically indicates the inflammatory damage in dogs and cats as a result of neutrophil response. When a pathogenic bacteria enters the body of the pet, neutrophil basically, which are the white blood cells, rush to the site of infestation and initiate the defense via three mechanisms. First, phagocytosis by directly engulfing the microorganism. Second, by production of reactive oxygen species that basically kill the pathogenic microorganisms. And third, by the production of neutrophil extracellular trap, that is NET. This neutrophil extracellular trap basically consists of oxidative enzymes as well as reactive oxygen species that destroy the pathogens. This activity of neutrophil is extremely important for the defense of host animals. However, dogs and cats are in continuous contact with the surroundings via the oral route. Continuous exposure of pathogens basically result in excessive secretion of compounds like reactive oxygen species that can react with the cell components and in long term result in disease such as cancer, locomotor malfunctioning, etc. So basically, we wanted to understand what exactly is the mechanism, how insect proteins can basically participate in this phenomena and stop the oxidative damage from neutrophils. In order to understand this, we actually conducted a study where we evaluated the antioxidant activity of insect proteins using the classical radical scavenging approach, where DPPH assay was used. Secondly, via the cellular approach, using the neutrophil response measurement. Thirdly, via the enzymatic approach, where we used myeloperoxidase model. Here in this research, the commercial chicken meal and fish meal were basically used as industrial benchmarks. First, on the top graph, I show the results of DPPH assay, which is one of the most commonly used antioxidant measurement assay that is used in the food and feed industry. In this assay, we found that insect proteins, which are basically indicated as BSFP, and hydrolyzed insect proteins, which are indicated as BSFHP and BSFAPH, have a very strong radical scavenging activity. Whereas chicken meal and fish meal have a pro-oxidant activity in this specific model. In the second model, basically using the neutrophil response assay, we again found that insect proteins derivative have a very strong reactive oxygen species scavenging activity. Whereas at final concentration, chicken meal and fish meal have mild to no activity. In the final model, the bottom right, finally, I show the results of the myeloperoxidase model that was realized using the CFED assay. We found that insect proteins derivative again have a very strong ability to scavenge reactive oxygen species, as well as also to inactivate the myeloperoxidase enzyme that is a nuisance during the oxidative process. This clearly indicates that the strong immune response modulation activity of insect protein derivatives when compared to chicken meal and fish meal. Insect proteins are also hypoallergenic in nature. In the photo on left, I basically show the mechanism of allergenicity in pets. After the initial exposure, an allergen is presented to the TH cells via the antigen presenting cells. This provides assistance in the regulation of cellular immunity and promotes isotope switching and production of specific IgE antibodies by the B cells. Subsequent antigen exposure induces cross-linking of antigen IgE complexes, and subsequent reactions lead to the activation and degranulation of the mast cells. The degranulation of the mast cell results in production of a wide range of negative molecules such as histamines. As shown in the figure on the right, these molecules can result in large variety of allergenic symptom on the pet body. Here you can see the inflation, the red itch marks on the ears of this cat. The key here is the first exposure and then the subsequent exposure. Since pets have minimal exposure to insect protein in the past, there are minimal chances that pets will develop allergy by the consumption of insect proteins. Several pet food companies are already taking the advantage of this fact and have launched insect-based hypoallergenic formulas in the market. Coming to the insect fats, first I will discuss the antimicrobial activity. As you can see that by the figure on the left, trilorin is the major triglyceride that is present in BSF fat. When consumed, this molecule is hydrolyzed into lauric acid and monolaurin by SN13 lipase that is present in the guts of the animals. Both lauric acid and monolaurin are known to have strong antimicrobial activities against a wide range of pathogens. The antimicrobial activity of BSF fat is already proven in vitro as well as in vivo. I'll not spend a lot of time here and quickly move to the next slide. In this slide, I will discuss the brain health improvement potential of BSF fat. As indicated from the previous slide, trilorin is the major component of BSF fat. Trilorin is a medium chain triglyceride. The photo in left indicates the digestion and the transportation of medium chain and long chain triglyceride in monogastric animals. The long chain triglycerides are first hydrolyzed into native fatty acids and transported via chylomicrons to peripheral tissues. A part of these fatty acids is basically deposited as fat in the tissues, whereas the remainder is used for the production of energy. Whereas in case of medium chain triglycerides, they are hydrolyzed into medium chain fatty acids and are then directly used for energy production. Therefore, consumption of medium chain triglycerides could provide instant energy to the brain, and feeding oils that are rich in medium chain triglycerides would help in improving the cognitive abilities of the pets. There are already some research papers that have proved the in vivo brain health improvement potential of medium chain triglycerides. Hence, feeding BSF fat that contains medium chain triglycerides could improve the health of the aging dogs and cats. Now I will discuss the bioactive properties of insect chitin. There is already some literature indicating that feeding BSF proteins could change the intestinal microbiota of fishes. There is also literature, the paper on the far right, that indicates that inclusion of chitin in the diets of fishes could improve the bacterial composition of the guts. This paper also indicates that dietary chitin could increase the counts of the beneficial lactic acid bacteria in the fish guts. And now I'll briefly discuss the findings of Huben et al. 2019. Huben basically confirmed that feeding BSF meal that contains chitin to rainbow trouts could improve the diversity of the bacterial colonies in distal intestines. This was also visible at phyla, order, as well as genus level. Authors also mention an increase in the count of beneficial lactic acid bacteria. They indicated that results possibly arise due to the presence of chitin in BSF. Finally, I will discuss something about the health and the behavior enhancement in poultry feed, in poultry that is fed with live larvae. Feeding live larvae to poultry could result in large variety of benefits, including reduced feather damage, improvement in leg health, reduction in the fearfulness of the poultry, and reduced aggressive feather pecking behavior. If you need more information about these activities, I propose you to please try to read the papers that are indicated in the slide below. Here, I provide a summary of the health promoting properties of BSF based feed ingredients. Feeding animals with BSF ingredients would have advantages in terms of antimicrobial activity, immune response modulation, hypoallergenicity, brain health improvement, and behavioral response modulation. Furthermore, if you have any questions about my slides, either you can ask me now, or you can also connect me on LinkedIn, or you can write me an email. I would be happy to answer your question. Thanks. Have a nice day.